Assalamu alaikum everyone. Today in this fifth part of life processes in living organisms, we will be studying process of sexual reproduction in plants.
There are three main steps. That steps are number one, pollination. First one is pollination. Second one, fertilization. Fertilization and the third one is germination. Germination. So, which are the three main steps in sexual reproduction of plants? First, pollination, second, fertilization, and third one is germination. So, first of all, we will see about the pollination. Okay. First process in the sexual reproduction of plant is pollination. In this pollination, what happens? See here, two reproductive organ of flower. One is carpel and another is stamen. Carpel, it is the individual unit of gynoecium, and the stamen is the individual unit of androecium. Okay. So in this stamen, see, two parts are there. One is anther, another is filament. And in this carpel, three different parts are there. One is stigma. In the middle, there is a stalk called as style, and the base in the means below this style to the base, there is a swollen part called as ovary. Okay, so these are the three parts of the carpel. Then in the pollination, what happen? We know that pollen grains, they are produced and stored inside of the anther. So anthers are bilobed, and inside of the anther, pollen grains are produced and stored. So pollen grain, transfer of the pollen grain from anther of stamen to the stigma of carpel is called as pollination. What is the meaning of pollination? It is the process of transfer of pollen grains from anther of stamen to the stigma of carpel is called as pollination. And here this pollination are of main two types. In your textbook two types are given, but actually they are of three types. First you will see the first type, its name is self pollination, and the second one is cross pollination. So first we will see self pollination. Self pollination. In this self pollination, see what happen. The transfer of pollen grain from anther of stamen to the stigma of carpel, it is takes place in the same flower of the same mother plant. Means here, suppose it is the stamen and it is the carpel. So here, transfer of pollen grain from anther of stamen to the stigma of carpel is takes place in the same flower of the same mother plant, or two different flower of the same mother plant. Means it may be takes place inside of the same flower, means from the stamen to the carpel, or from this stamen to the next flower in the carpel, and that is called as self pollination. Understood? So self pollination means the transfer of pollen grain from anther of stamen to the stigma of carpel in the same flower of the same mother plant, or two different flower of the same mother plant. Understood? So it is self pollination. Then the cross pollination is next is cross pollination. In the cross pollination, what happen? This transfer of the pollen grain from anther of stamen to the stigma of carpel is takes place in two different flower of two different mother plant, but of the same species. Here two different mother plant means two, the plants are different, means one flower is on the one plant and another flower is on the another plant. Okay, means two different plants are there, and in that two different plant, two different flowers are there. So from one flower of the one mother plant to another flower of the another mother plant, and that is called as cross pollination. Understood? So here cross pollination means transfer of pollen grain from anther of stamen to the stigma of carpel from one flower of the one mother plant to the another flower of the another mother plant, but of the same species. Okay, that is called as cross pollination. But of the same species means that plants are either both are of rose or both are of the sunflower. Okay, that is called as same species. And then one more pollination is there, which is not given in your textbook. that is the hybridization. We know that this hybridization process, it is used to increase the yield of the crop, correct, as well as to produce the plant with more resistant power to the diseases. So this hybridization process, what happened in this hybridization process? Here two different plants are taken of the two different species, and the cross pollination, it is done purposely to increase the yield of the plant or to increase the resistance to different types of diseases. So that is called as hybridization. For example, here pomato. So pomato is the plant which is produced by carrying out the cross pollination between the potato and the tomato. Okay, so in that plant we can take at the same time two different fruits. One is potato and another is tomato. Okay, so tomato can grow on the stem and potato can grow on the roots of that same plant. So that is called as pomato. So these are the three types of pollination, but only we have to study about the cell pollination and cross pollination. So in the cell pollination, what happen? The transfer of pollen grain from anther of stamen to the stigma of carpel of the same flower of the same mother plant or two different flower of the same mother plant is takes place. Okay, but in the cross pollination, what happen? That two different plants are there, but of the same species, means the transfer of pollen grain from one flower to the other flower, which are belongs to two different plants but of the same species, called as cross pollination. See, the next step is fertilization after the pollination. So in that pollination, what happen? Only the transfer of pollen grain from anther of stamen to the stigma of carpel. So in this fertilization, what happen? Here, see, after the deposition of pollen grain on the stigma, it is the part of carpel called as stigma, and this one is stalk, is style, and below that there is a ovary. Swollen part is the ovary. Okay. So after the deposition of the pollen grain, what happen? This stigma, it become more sticky. Stigma become more sticky, and because of that sticky nature of the stigma, this pollen grain start to germinate there. Okay, so after the deposition, there is a germination of the pollen grain, and in that germination, what happen? This pollen grain, it bear a tubular structure like this. It is the pollen grain, suppose, and it bear one tubular structure, and that tubular structure is called as pollen tube. What we call for it? Pollen tube. So after the germination, here pollen tube, it is generated or it is created by this pollen grain. So here it bear a pollen tube, or it is the tubular structure called as pollen tube. Then this pollen tube, from this pollen grain, it travel through the style. This style is hollow part, and that's why this pollen tube can travel through this style. And this pollen tube, it carry two male gamete along with that. See, like this, this pollen tube has two male gamete. Okay, because we know that in each pollen grain there are two male gametes. So after the formation of the pollen tube, that pollen tube travel through the hollow style and then reaches to the ovary. Here the ovary is present. Inside of the ovary there are two or more ovules, and in each ovule there is a embryo sac. It is very transparent covering, and this covering, which is transparent, it is made up of by the cell division, that is called as meiosis. So it is made up of just few cell, and that's why it is transparent in nature. Okay, so inside of the embryo sac there are ovules. Understood? So here, see, inside the ovule, which things are present? One is the egg cell, and another is two haploid polar cells. So two haploid polar cells and one egg cell, which is a female gamete, it is present in each ovary. Okay, so this pollen tube, it travel through the style and reaches to the ovary. inside of the embryo sac. Then what happen? These two male gametes, which are carried by this pollen tube, one male gamete, it fuses with the egg cell. Here, it fuses with the egg cell. One male gamete will fuse or will unite with the egg cell, and another male gamete, it will fuse with the two polar secondary nucleus. Okay, so they are called as polar nuclei, two polar secondary nuclei, and these polar nuclei at the same time egg cell, they are haploid in nature, means they are single. Okay, they are haploid in nature. So one male gamete, it fuses with the egg cell, which is a female gamete, and here another male gamete, it fuses with the two polar nuclei which are present inside of each ovule. So in this way, here see, after the fusion of one male gamete with egg cell or the female gamete, zygote is produced. So after the fusion of male and female gamete, zygote is produced, and after the fusion of here polar nuclei, haploid polar nuclei, and the male gamete, endosperm is produced. What is produced? Endosperm. And that's why this type of fertilization in the plant is called as double fertilization. Why it is called as double fertilization? Because here pollen tube carry two male gamete, and out of that two male gamete, one male gamete fuses with the germ cell, that is the egg cell inside of the ovule, to form the zygote. At the same time, second male gamete, it fuses with the polar nuclei, which are two polar nuclei, to form the endosperm. So in this way, two times the fusion takes place, and that's why it is called as double fertilization. So fertilization in the plant is called as double fertilization, because two male gamete, different way they react or they unite with the egg cell and the polar nuclei. Okay, so after the fusion of this egg cell and the male gamete, zygote is produced, and after the fusion of polar nuclei and the male gamete, second male gamete, endosperm is produced. And this endosperm, the function of the endosperm is to provide the nutrition. What is the function of the endosperm? To provide the nutrition for growth of the zygote. Okay, so there is a development of zygote inside of this ovary, and for development of the zygote, nutritional cells are required. So these nutritive cells, they are provided by the endosperm, means endosperm provide the nutrition for the development of the zygote. Understood? See, after the formation of the zygote, this zygote multiply many times, means mitotically it divide, and then here embryo is produced after mitotic division of the zygote. Then this embryo, it develop entirely inside of that ovary. Then here endosperm only provide the nutrition for it. Then after the development here, what happen? The ovules which are present inside of the ovary, that ovule transform into the seed. So here ovules transform into the seed, and the ovary, this entire ovary, it transform into the fruit. So ovary is transformed into the fruit. In this way, here fruits are formed in the plant. Then when this fruit burst or open, the seeds get free from it, and when these seeds fall on the suitable substratum, they start to germinate. Now we will see the next process, its name is germination. See, the last process in the sexual reproduction of plant is germination. So after the formation of the seeds from the ovule and the fruit from the ovary, when that seed get the suitable condition, then that seed has the future plant, it develop into the seedling under the appropriate condition. Okay, so in this way, here small plantlets or the seedlings are formed from the seed after the fertilization, and then followed by the germination. Understood? So in this way, here new plants are produced.